Yeah.
I think ESC's draft here is smart. They're taking away both of the tools that SKT used to beat Longshu.
Yeah.
So they're forcing them into potentially an uncomfortable situation, but you know, the jungler's going to be left up here. Shen removed as Crazy jumped on that one pretty quickly, and you'd have to say you're probably pretty happy with a Duke versus Crazy matchup if you were SK Telecom that doesn't involve a million globals.
Wow, the Ryze ban coming in as well. So, yep, not wanting to give over that Ryze to Faker.
Well, they just want a first pick Vladimir again. That's what ESC wants here. Now, whether SKT is going to allow them to do that is another story.
I feel like you just ban the Vlad. Who cares?
Are you worried about the Bard, though? Clearly, Wolf doesn't want to play it, and Key has shown how dangerous he can be on that champion. And yes, there is the Vladimir ban. That is, I think, the smart way to go forward.
I think you're much more worried about the Vladimir than the Bard, even though Key's Bard, obviously, is really, really good. But
Temp did a great job on it, though. So
yeah.
Now you take away the Rek'Sai, which is Bengi's bread and butter champion.
Or Gragas.
Wow. Yeah. First picking the Gragas, so a lot of faith. But you know what, Doa? I like this pick because ESC is saying, well, all we did last game was groove up and hard engage on you, catch you out and kill you. And what does that well? It is the Gragas. So Azir Sivir.
Yeah, so a little bit less ability to catch people up now that the Karma and the Sivir are unavailable to ESC ever.
And now this is the time that the Varus came in. I theorized that it may be a Varus for Tempt in the last game. You can still switch it up, of course. You know, Varus and Gragas, not the greatest synergy together, but you have to be very careful about how you use those ultimates. But you can catch somebody if you can bring somebody to you for a Chain of Corruption. They can be used well together.
True.
But certainly we've seen a lot of Varus versus Azir matchups. Maybe he's a little bit worried. The Elise still on the table. Bengi likely to play the Elise, which would force him into a cleanse on the Varus.
And maybe the, well, Kalista Ahri would be.
It's more hard engage.
Different.
It's just more hard engage. Why not take the Kalista Alistar here?
Yeah.
How did you win the last game? Hard engage. So if SKT, I think this is smart. If SKT is going to continue to try and fight you 3v5, then just play something that will just destroy them. They can't escape from Kalista Alistar with a Gragas there too. And we've seen many times this season when Kalista has been picked, yes, the pick rate has gone down, but most of the time it's considered a Sivir counterpick. So they want to actually deal with the Sivir well in the laning phase.
Yep, that's right. So the Rek'Sai can go over to Bengi if they want to take it. And the Braum, I suppose. Wouldn't be bad.
Well, would give Wolf some more mobility and tankiness so he's not punished for being out of position quite so much. And he has the Glacial Fissure to disengage with.
He died a lot last game, too. So I think definitely wanting to play something a bit more tanky. Looks like it might be the Elise for Bengi after all.
I think you do take the Elise.
Oh, wow. Soraka? Really?
Want the sustain, so SK Telecom saying that they want a kite here. Nope, Braum at the last second, so they're going to switch it up. But we'll see if Bang can block some important projectiles.
So saving that top pick for last is SK Telecom. Now, two final picks for ESC ever. They could go with the Blanc. It would certainly be safe, I suppose.
It would be, and they probably are less inclined to take Varus into the Braum, and especially into the Elise Azir combination. That is potentially quite deadly when it comes to creating picks in the mid lane, so you may want something a bit more mobility. And taking a look at that Malka, man, just insane amounts of hard engage once again from ESC. And you know what, Doa? This is what I was hoping to see from them all season, because this is the thing that they're good at. They spend a long time trying out other strategies, and they just couldn't be effective with them. And I think when you have a new team, that it's best just to play to your strengths, even if they're not the most meta strengths, just because if you could do one thing well, maybe you can take a series or a game here or there with it.
Yeah, I mean, when you're a newer team like that, oh, and wow, the last-minute change over to Hecarim.
Well, Bold, Gnar still available. Duke does play a good Gnar, and that may just, in fact, come in at the end here.
I think Gnar makes a lot of sense. You're not going to send a Taric or a Braum to the top lane, so what's it going to be?
Could be the Aurelia pick.
Okay.
Clearly a pretty strong laner and will be able to put some pressure down early onto the Hecarim, but come the late game, man, the Hecarim is just so devastating.
Yeah.
His team fight presence is huge. Getting into those back lines is pretty simple for him. They've got a lot of champions that can provide flank pressure with the LeBlanc and the Hecarim, but just engage, engage, engage for ESC. They've got good pick pressure too. If they can isolate a target for the LeBlanc, pick him off.
I like it. I feel like it's kind of what we saw KT Rolster doing a little bit last year, you know, just super heavy engage every game, and, you know, until they got kind of better at everything, this is what really worked, and it seems like ESC Ever is kind of finding that niche too.
Yeah, exciting. Exciting to see them play. So a lot of pick potential here. Still good damage in teamfights. Good scaling for ESC. SK Telecom, they're not going to have that same tankiness that ESC is going to be fielding with the Hecarim, Alistar, and the Gragas. So have to play a little bit more cautiously. And we'll see if they can actually pull it off this time. Good skirmishing, though, from SK Telecom. And they are going to be very fast with the Irelia and the Sivir combination.
Yep. So game number two, SK Telecom looking for a chance to tie things up against ESC Ever. Yet another sentence I didn't expect I would say today, but something that's becoming all too common with SK Telecom this season. Let's see if they can do it. Force a game three. It's go time. Infernal Drake will grace us with its fiery presence at the beginning of game number two between ESC and SK Telecom. And, you know, another thing to think about, I suppose, as we go into this is, if that early cheese hadn't happened in game number one, you know, how would things have been different?
Yep. I don't know, because the coordination was off, but Bang being behind certainly didn't help. If anything, Bang has probably been the most consistent player on SK Telecom this season.
True.
So putting him behind can potentially put you in a hole, but we shall see if he doesn't die immediately in this game.
At least Wolf's having a good time.
Smacking his shield around.
Oh, Brom, are you okay, man? That's, wow, Brom having a nervous breakdown in the river. That does happen sometimes, I suppose.
Nervous breakdowns in rivers? Does that happen to you from time to time?
Well, I mean, I think it happens to champions on Summoner's Rift a lot, is what I'm saying, you know, because you just have this moment where you realize that you're a champion in League of Legends and you're never going to be anywhere else besides this map right here.
I think what I learned, though, is not to take you near the Han River. That's what I learned. It's my takeaway.
Well, or don't let me be in the Han River anyway.
They'll just keep you away from it entirely, you know.
I mean, it's hard to do. It's a giant river that goes to the middle of the city, so good luck.
Yeah, okay. I'll try. Play river defense here.
Okay. Well, then things got odd.
It's a pretty standard start here. Both teams, two lanes, will be taking a jungle camp. And what exactly is the plan here for SKT? They are going to start on the top side of the map with the jungle. And that means that they may not have an early gank onto Crazy, but that has to be their focus, is snowballing Duke before Crazy can get into terrifying late-game Hecarim status.
True enough.
So Crazy going to have to be really cautious, because the ganking threat of an Elise Aurelia cannot be underestimated.
Yeah.
So they're using Equilibrium Strike at level 2 just to even up the HP, and Bengi is going to go for a 3-minute gank. So.
Yep, coming in with that red buff, and Bengi is back. Can he have a successful gank? His first game back in a few weeks. Here he comes, walking right into lane. Duke engaging with Crazy already. Duke lower health. He can stun him with that Equilibrium Strike. Teleport coming in. Crazy pushing Duke back. Bengi trying to find an angle here. It's not going to work out. Blast flashes for the Body Slam. First blood onto Duke. And man, that could not really have gotten much worse for SKT.
Wow, great read there from ESC. They were so ready for that gank,
yeah.
Doa. I mean, we already saw Bless was at the top side, hunting around the jungle, seeing where Bengi was on the map, and then also the wave pressure was pushed into the mid lane, so Temp got an absolutely free TP right there. Did use his flash and didn't get an assist, so there is a bit of an asterisk there. Bengi may be able to make a counterplay, but man, just stacking people into that top side, and Bless shows up big with the body slam flash kill. Just gorgeous, but I mean, there's nothing that can stop the TP. They disrespect the double TP. And Crazy decides to go aggressive, shove back, and Bengi, I don't know where that cocoon was going.
That was, I didn't even see that the first time because it was so off.
Man. Wow, that was a huge misplay.
All right, you're benched.
from Bengi. I don't...
Bring back Blank.
I mean, he doesn't have flash. There's not even any kind of prediction there, and there was no one else to be cocooning. So just a missed skill shot, mechanical error there from Bengi.
Maybe he thought Crazy was going to head towards Tri-Brush to loop around, but that's got to be the reason.
I mean, Crazy could not physically have ever made it to that location at that time.
I don't know.
That's a misclick.
I guess so. It's a pretty bad time to have that happen. And nice little gold lead for ESC Ever already here in game number two.
Yeah. So that's going to be pretty good. But they do know the Temp Slash is down, so they're waiting to see if he'll use his W or if they can make any kind of play. But they're not going to.
Well, Temp and the rest of ESC Ever playing some pretty... calm, calculated League of Legends here, which is good to see. I think we're in for especially if ESC Ever 2-0s SK Telecom, I think we're in for a really good second half of the season.
Yeah.
In terms of...
For KT, yes.
Well, for anybody, really. I mean, KT may have a chance. It's not like they never win championships. You know, they won in 2014. They made it to Worlds, where they did pretty well there.
Yep. So got knocked out by the second place team, Rocks Tigers.
Yeah, so once in a while KT's okay. They become OKT. Is that an SKT?
I would say winning a championship is better than okay, but that's all right.
Oh, yeah. That's what SK Telecom generally does. But world champion Faker on the run, slowed down by Bless. Faker's got his flash, he's got his exhaust, he's not going to use either. Just accepts his fate.
Key is here just to pick it up.
I love it.
His bot lane was not there on the map at all, so Key got a bit of a free roam. Meanwhile, Loken happy just to freeze in this bottom side, and Faker just wandering off into the wilderness, accepting his death, I guess.
That was just a this is my life now death. It's like, well, I could try to escape, but it's already over.
Bless didn't have ult. It's only level 5, and he didn't have flash either.
Man. This is... bad.
This is certainly not SKT's finest hour tonight.
Maybe you do need to keep me away from the Han River.
I knew it, though.
I do say never bet against SKT, and I'm probably always going to say that, but I may actually be wrong. It's possible.
Well, there's a lot of season left.
There is. And SK Telecom is... They've never looked... this bad, though, in the last couple of years.
Yeah.
Last year or so.
Yeah, that's probably a true statement.
All right, here comes Bengi.
He's seen
by Ward.
He doesn't know where Bless is.
Nope, Bless knows where he is.
Looking for a blue buff. And here we go, the plays are beginning.
He's going to find a blue player, and he's going to be blue as he gets launched against the wall there. Bengi has his flash, going to repel over the Rift Scuttler, explosive cast, throwing his wall in. Whoa, the alley-oop.
Served up.
Wow.
Well, he had no idea where the enemy jungler was.
This has gone from beating SK Telecom to styling upon SK Telecom.
I don't know what's going on with SKT's junglers, because neither of them seem to have any respect to the fact about where people could be on the map.
Yeah.
They did want to take advantage of the pressure that they had in the mid and the top lanes to try and do an invade and take away this blue buff, but... Crazy and Tempt were reading that super well, and Bless showing up once again. Bless is having a great series on this Gragas.
Yeah, absolutely. And things are rough. Now, maybe the one bright spot for SK Telecom is that Duke has been able to get a decent CS lead over Crazy, but he's also died, and Crazy has 2 assists, so it really isn't that different. So never mind everything I just said.
cool.
It's all terrible.
Yeah, that the assist certainly helping out. And Ninja Tabby first for Crazy just to give him some sort of relief against the auto attacks from the Stinger Aurelia. And Crazy is setting up for a gank here. He's hiding a brush right now. They want to kill Faker. Again.
That's right.
You're going to dive him.
Yeah, looks like they actually are.
They know he's there now, though. Faker knows he's there. He was seen on a ward by the Raptors.
Bengi there, too, so I don't think this dive is going to actually happen. No. I think you're getting a little bit more CS. But SK Telecom, pretty terrified right now. I mean, the really scary thing is if ESC ever can get this Infernal Drake, then things are extra bad. Faker in a little bit of trouble here. He's got his flash, he's got his exhaust. He may not use them, but they're there in case he needs them, really.
Well, I love the way Crazy's playing this lane so far, because the fact is on Hecarim, when you're playing in this top lane, Stuke just chunks him out pretty mercilessly. Now it's going to go early, but when you're playing on this Hecarim, you don't want to walk up to farm deep into the lane, and it's better just to lose a few CS to try and make plays, because when you have that ghost and you have the ultimate, you can go ahead and just dive the mid lane pretty ruthlessly and indiscriminately in the mid game, so why not just leave there? Yeah, you're going to miss a few CS, but you have to walk up to them in melee range too and get bad trades versus Aurelia anyway, so fall behind and see if you can just make plays, especially if you can get this LeBlanc fed.
That's the plan.
So that instead of just exposing yourself in a long lane on a champion that doesn't have very many tools to escape, just go ahead and see if you can feed somebody else on the map.
I suppose as far as the 1v1 goes, Duke still has the edge there.
Oh, yes. Certainly. The Aurelia, despite the death, still doing a lot of work in his top lane, forcing Crazy to go back again. Does pick up a Bombi Cinder, so I thought we were going to see the Trinity Force, but we will not. We will see some more pushing HP. But Crazy got a TP right back into half his HP and damage.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Gragas parties. If I was a 1-0-2 Gragas at 11 minutes into the game against SK Telecom, I would be partying too.
I'd be feeling pretty good about myself. And
oh, yeah.
Bless has every reason to. He has been the more effective jungler in this series.
Oh, Brahmalt on to Loken. Bang coming down here. Flash is used by both supports. And Bang, if you would have connected with that Boomerang Blade, would have left Loken with very little health.
Yeah. Nice aggression from SKT, realizing that with their wards that Key was in the river, and Loken playing a bit too aggressively under those circumstances.
Well, this might be able to be an Infernal Drake for SK Telecom if they pull back, because Faker and Bengi are there. I don't know. Maybe they can. Yeah, they're going for it.
Crazy doesn't have TP, so with TP advantage, this is definitely a good call from SK Telecom.
Yeah. So Wolf and Bank getting aggressive in bot lane, just shoving Key and Loken out, and it's a big pickup to get that Infernal Drake.
Yeah, that's absolutely huge. So good aggression from SK Telecom to give them space to
another
do that.
One.
And Crazy also just misusing his TP in the top lane and getting chunked out for it, so he immediately had to go back. That was just basically a free objective.
Yeah.
SK Telecom recognizing that timing window and making the most of it. Meanwhile, they blesses thinking about what he can do up here, but Crazy just doesn't have very much damage, and he's just going to build, looks like, a Glacial Shroud next, so it's going to be a pretty low damage Hecarim. Not that they need Hecarim to do a lot of damage with this composition. Certainly Tempt and Loken will provide enough.
Megan Wolf moving into the river. Going on a bit of a warding mission, it looks like, as Crazy comes down from the top lane. They're going to go after Bless. Try to take his Raptors, and they will. Fight for the ward, and nobody getting explosive cast used. Bless cocooned, though, by Bengi, so no follow-up there. Meanwhile, Crazy throws Duke into the wall. Duke, though, is not going to be too bothered by that.
No, still doing A-OK in the trades. Loken and Key having a much harder time in the laning phase. Interesting, they had Berserker Grease against BF Sword for quite some time and only now building into the Blade of the Ruined King, so taking a bit of a hit there. That is reflected in the CS total. Blue buff taken by Tempted. They're going to go straight onto a red invade. They already have the pink ward prepped.
Yep, Bengi's there, though.
And Bengi like will die if he is found, so...
Uh-oh. Oh, boy. Bengi. Will the prophecy come true? No, he flashed. The Monte Cristo prophecy. Well, maybe you meant Duke.
I did.
I see. Good. I thought you meant Duke.
I missed a lot
more sense. Yeah. Well, Blade Surge getting Duke farther down lane before he dies. Tempt with another kill.
And then TP right back into the mid lane so that Faker's not going to be able to chip this one out. So ESC, once again, just outplaying SKT on the map. Free kill, trying to normalize this top lane, gave Crazy some advantages, take away the red buff, so good, good invade. And roam from Tempt, and Bless there to set up kills, and it's just, Bless is doing a hell of a lot more in this series than the SKT junglers.
Wow, Bless onto Bengi's explosive cask. That was just a, hey, yo, what's up, I can waste my ult on you moment.
Yeah, not going to go in there, Faker. Certainly could have been there faster than Tempt could.
Sure.
Not going to try and make a play. At least Wolf and Bang are amping up the pressure, and having the better wave clear with that Sivir early on means that Oaken just has to stay under his turret.
There is that, yeah.
But Bless is making the right call here. You want this Hecarim to start getting ahead, to start doing well. Finally going to be building a Trinity Force now. Crazy moving towards the Phage as his next item. So getting some basic resists with that armor and transitioning into some more offensive items.
Yep, Bless is just going to grab his own red buff. And Faker has been able to put some decent pressure onto this turret in the mid lane. Yeah. Not bad.
Well, he's been successful at this. Yeah. Game number one and now game number two this evening. But it hasn't actually helped. Faker, for the most part, has been playing pretty well, but sometimes the rest of his team letting him down.
Lamp the pink ward. A cocoon on the key. It will do a little bit of damage. Nope. Not a whole lot.
Duke there. Just waiting in the river. He wants to get some more trades in. Oh, wow. Double distortion.
Yeah, attempt actually taking a big chunk out of Faker's Azir. All right, Duke just, wondering if there was maybe a gank coming in, but spots nobody with the scrying orb, so he knows that Crazy's just being a little bit aggressive.
Indeed. Crazy going to be falling back now. You can see he's very worried. Crazy going for the blue trinket pretty early on in this game, not something that we see from a lot of top laners, but does make sense when you consider Hecarim and if he does face check a Bengi, there's basically no escape for him because the cocoon will be able to find him barring any more mechanical errors.
Yep. Minute 20 until the next Infernal Drake is up. And we'll see if SKT can find a way to take that one.
It's going to be really hard, I think, for SKT. Sure, they have the Infernal Drake, but the Abyssal Scepter now completed for Tempt.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like they'd be able to fight for it, per se.
Crazy popped his ghost. I'm not sure what his game is. I think he was trying to maybe fool Duke into thinking that there was somebody else there.
Huh, try to get the flash or something?
But that did not work at all.
Nope.
Oh, he has to be really careful. Duke going to draw a couple turret hits, but not where you want to be 45 seconds into a Drake.
Yeah.
Because Crazy's going to have to go back, and this may open up an opportunity for Duke to deal with this top lane turret and swing this gold lead into SK Telecom's favor.
Yeah, that would be big if he could take out that turret and then teleport down for Dragon. It's up for 25 seconds. Wow, Bless going in. Gets Cocoon, though. Has to be careful. Still has that explosive cast. You know, Key's also been chunked out in a big way as well.
SKT just
careful.
Yeah, getting the poke damage down, methodically moving forward towards Infernal Drake number two.
Well, they know they really need this one. It's up now. Right now, there we go. Ward's taken out. They've got the vision back again. And they may just go and start this. Yep, they will. Okay.
It's crazy.
A little bit risky.
Going to commit to this. He could TP. There he goes.
Yep, teleporting in. Loken coming up from the bottom as well. SK Telecom still half that health of the dragon remaining. They need to back away. ESC could just take over. Faker coming down. Duke could teleport in if he wanted to.
No, he doesn't. Not yet, at least.
Yep.
I want to see if they can get this top lane turret down, but the dragon has been re-leashed, and there's a lot of Kalista Spears in it.
I don't think SKT wants to give this Infernal Drake over to ESC ever. All right, Sivir pop, they're coming in. There's Duke on that Aurelia, teleporting into the back, crazy on top of it immediately, though. Explosive cask splits up SK Telecom, Wolf blocking some damage, crazy getting in the back line, so Loken having to disengage. Duke picks up the first kill of the fight, Bless too low to keep fighting. Faker coming in completely untouched on this Azir so far. Temp very, very low. Duke still chasing. Faker with the kill, and SK Telecom looks like they've got this one.
Absolutely awful decision from ESC. Faker coming in right now. He does get punted underneath the turret.
Oh, man. Faker getting a little bit too close there. They're going to keep fighting.
Bang flashing for that, too, but couldn't get the second proc of the Boomerang Blade. Still going to get the bottom turret and then transition into a Drake. Duke is high enough HP to actually tank this one out. Still overcommitment, over-aggression from Faker, but man, ESC just left Bless in the back of the pit, getting auto-attacked by the Infernal Drake until he nearly died. Explosive cask was wasted, and then as SKT pushed down the river, they tried to actually make some sort of follow-up play, but everyone was too low. They didn't have their engage any longer.
Wow, and Tempt teleporting there to maybe try to pick somebody off? Not sure.
I mean, Bless just stays in the back of this pit, getting chunked out, and they decide to engage. Explosive cask is down. What really are they going to do? Okay, you get the Hecarim into the back line, but look at Duke. He just eliminates the Kalista immediately. They took far too much damage from the Infernal Drake, and they felt they had to go for that because they had already committed their TP to the attempt, but they were split. Some of them in the pit and some of them on the bottom side of the river. SKT sticking together as a five-man unit. And Faker here, it was a good move by Key. But with the punt available to Alistair, I have to respect that. And instead, Bang gets a little bit desperate and flashes for a kill onto a Key, which never materializes as the first hit of the Boomerang Blade wasn't enough and the second one didn't land.
Yep. Well, that does leave SK Telecom with two Infernal Drakes at this point. And they have taken a bit of a gold lead. It's going to be extended by this kill on the top lane turret. So despite being down in kills and kind of losing out on some earlier skirmishes, it kind of looks like SKT is coming back pretty strong in this one.
And longer the game goes on, too, the effective gold lead is absolutely massive with the two Infernal Drakes. The value of those stats just increasing more and more and more as time goes on.
Yeah, for sure.
ESC probably going to have to pull a rabbit out of the hat here because it may only look like 1,000 gold, but it is going to be a lot more come 5-10 minutes from now.
SK Telecom's walking into the mid lane to try to push this one down. It's really low. Faker's done a good job of poking that out all game. Good wave clear press our ESC though, so we'll stand for the moment.
Yeah, this is a potentially rough situation. Faker does have to back off. He doesn't want to get picked off. Engage still extremely strong from ESC, but man, props to SKT's bottom lane this game. Their aggressive play was the reason why this was even possible, because if we had seen Loken and Key start to get rolling and then dominate the bottom side, nearly impossible to take that Drake away from the Kalista, but this is one of those games where, because Bless was paying so much attention to trying to help out the Hecarim on the top side, they didn't play around the actual Drakes that were appearing in this game. You need to change your focus into the bottom side of the map if you start to see two Infernal Drakes in a row spawning. Even if your top laner is having a rough time of it, being denied quite a bit of CS, because the advantage that you have with a Kalista with two Infernal Drakes early, you should be winning that bottom side of the map. You should be ganking there. You should be teleporting down there. You have a TP advantage already with two TPs to one. So I think it's just a misread by the team of ESC as to where they needed to go with regards to the Drake RNG.
Seems that way. All three outer turrets down now in favor of SK Telecom. And now we see how quickly SKT can possibly close this game out.
Well,
so far so good.
Yeah, but pushing forward more is going to be difficult, so I think they have to start turning their sights to a Baron at this stage.
Probably.
Before they go any deeper down the lane. That's where the vision control is going to go. They are fortunate in that they have all of their outer turrets remaining except for the mid lane turret, so it will be easier to push up the top side and then fall back to the safety of the river.
Very true. Crazy pushing the bot lane now, trying to be as much of a split-pushing threat as he can.
Wow, Yomu's for Duke. Aggressive Aurelia build.
Very.
But this leaves him somewhat vulnerable to getting picked off by the LeBlanc.
Yeah. All right, Zipper ultimate. SKT's going in. Bless the target. Teleport coming in, though, for ESC. Braum ultimate use. Faker already on the disengage. And now ESC chasing down the Sazir. Bang is there, though. And they need to back away.
Wow. TB used there by Crazy. Duke holds strong with his. So SKT just getting the ultimates out of ESC and then backing off. So now the TP advantage, and this is where Duke is really going to shine. He's going to be able to tear through these minion waves with Trinity Force and Yomu's Ghostblade.
Wow.
So the split push is the big threat right now. Great job by SKT.
Tons of damage on the Loken, too.
Why is he teleporting?
Work. I don't know. He just wanted to join. I guess they want to engage on this. Braum ultimate, or not Braum ultimate, the Q from Wolf misses.
They don't have Sivir ult. They can't engage right now.
Yeah, I'm not sure why they went for that, but it does allow them to put pressure on Baron, but he could have just walked down and done that anyway.
Yeah, they should have just held strong there and tried to play for the tier two in the bottom side. It's like a little bit trigger happy from Duke with the teleport, but they still go for the Baron.
Well, they've got a lot of damage with those two Infernal Drake buffs, and it doesn't look like ESC can even think about opposing this.
I mean, they have Azir, Sivir, and the Aurelia. They're going to be able to burn through that Baron super fast. That's what they get. So now the split push may be able to commence. Temp did use his TP, so nobody with teleport right now. Means the 4-1, a very good option for SK Telecom.
Next dragon up right about now. And SKT has a lot of power to go after that. It is a Cloud Drake, though, so who cares?
No one cares any longer, though. Nope. It's just about pushing.
You know, I tried for a while, you know, but even I had to admit that. Cloud Drake just was pretty useless.
Really? Even you? That was the bar?
Even me, man. I mean, because I tried. You know, I really tried. I was like, well, you know, maybe if you miss a skill shot and you don't have Cloud Drake, it's because you didn't have Cloud Drake. And if you hit one after you have Cloud Drake, it's because you had Cloud Drake. But I think I was lying to myself, Monty.
You were lying to the fans too, Doa.
But it was more about me lying to myself. That was a true tragedy.
Was it?
It was. And so now I have to admit that Cloud Drake isn't that great.
Do you get to admit it to the fans too?
I admit it to the fans too, yeah. Cloud Drake may actually be the worst buff ever.
Would you even call it a buff at that point?
Yeah, it's just a bad buff. I mean, it does buff you. It does increase one of your attributes. Just in a nearly meaningless way.
Well, good news, Doa. It may be giving you more out-of-combat move speed soon.
Oh, yeah. Really?
Yep.
Wow.
Don't change it in any other way. Just more out-of-combat move speed.
Right, sure.
Sorry, they give it enough, and all of a sudden it will actually become useful. And we can call it the Rotation Dragon.
Or the Dragtation, or Ro-Dragon.
No, we're not going to call it either of those things. That's not very catchy, Doa. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to shoot that down.
You don't like Ro-Dragon?
Stop trying to make Ro-Dragon a thing. It's not going to be a thing.
Hashtag Ro-Dragon. It's a thing now. I'm making it a thing.
It's not going to be a thing, Doa.
Ro-Dragon. Hashtag. Better for the Ro-Dragon.
Well, not too successful on the split pushing here for SK Telecom. They haven't increased their gold lead dramatically since taking this Baron. We'll see. They've got some more time left on the Baron. Now they're going to be coming into this mid lane. Duke is going to join up with the rest of his team.
Yeah, it has been interesting. They really haven't done a lot. Well, they've caught Key, and that Alistar in a big trouble. A little bit of trouble. They managed to cause the ultimate to come out, so that is a bit of a win. Having that down, it's going to make it a little bit easier to push that mid lane tier 2. He can't really be part of that fight. Yeah, they're just going to have to give it up. SKT still pushing down the mid lane. Wait for that. Oh, wow, they catch Les with the cocoon. Wolf trying to do the counter engage. Key loading up the Fates Call. Crazy going deep with that Hecarim. Gets low. Key thrown in with the Fates Call. That's going to be some kills coming in for SK Telecom, though. And they may be able to end it right here. Explosive cask used, and this is looking pretty bad for ESC.
Yeah, they couldn't stop Duke from getting huge in this game in spite of the attention that they paid into the top side of the map. And, man, giving up those early Drakes, SKT really capitalizing on that.
No kidding.
And running away with this one.
That's right. There goes Nexus turret number one. Temp still up to try to stop it. Nexus turret number two. Looks like Crazy may come back up at the very end. Oh, but Temp completely caught out, and that's a kill that should secure the game. SK Telecom, Faker coming in, missing with the Emperor's Divide. Loken still up. Tuka thrown into the fountain.
Uh-oh.
And SKT getting pushed back here. Oh, boy. It may not be quite over yet.
It will not be.
Oh.
The death timers aren't going to be long enough for ESC to really strike back, but Benki trying to run away.
Oh, no. It's bad.
The Cloud Drake, it's working, Doa.
Is it?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Oh,
double kill
not.
For Loken. No, it's not. It's not saving them. It's going to be an ace.
It was close, though, before Crazy TP'd in. So an ace as SKT, not able to take out this Nexus, but ESC really not going to be able to push too far out on this one.
Not too much. I think they needed another Cloud Drake. That was really the key. All right.
You almost got your wish of Cloud Drake being useful, though.
That's true. That's true. But even then, it just wasn't.
You're right. It wasn't. I said almost for a reason.
Yep. That's putting the period on the end of that sentence. Well, the Nexus at about half health. SK Telecom, though. Oh, boy.
It was a good hold from ESC.
It was, yeah.
Probably not going to have a major effect on the outcome of this game, particularly with Baron up in just a minute and a half.
Yeah, everybody from SK Telecom back up again. See what they can do. Crazy taking a long time to kill that Rift Sculler.
I mean, you know the game's over when you ace the enemy team at 30 minutes and you can't even take one of their two remaining outer turrets.
Yeah, that's a good point. All right, let's watch that replay again. So SKT, they catch Temp. It looks like it's going well at that point.
Yeah, Loken does have a QSS, so actually nice flash there from Loken onto Faker. So he gets a lot of damage off with that rune and Hurricane Duke.
Yeah.
A little bit over-eager, punted into the back. Faker then with the exhaust on top of him just can't deal any more damage. And Loken just hopping through the minion wave. Getting inching closer to Benki and Bang. And there's a team, see the Cloud Drake kicking in right there.
Yep. Not kicking enough.
Trying to, he is getting further away. Sadly, there is a teleport Hecarim.
Yep. That's an ace. So, SK Telecom looking to set up another winning push. We'll see if they can. Still 6,000 gold ahead. And quite a bit of power with those two Infernal Drakes.
Huge split push.
Yep.
Still there, courtesy of the Aurelia. No Trinity Force yet for Crazy. He's been forced into a build path that required him to finish a couple of tank items before he can actually reasonably go for that.
You've got the super minion wave pushing in the mid lane, though. Baron up in a minute. No, Baron up in about 10 seconds. Dragon up in about a minute. SKT just going to go for the Baron to try to finish things off.
Yeah, no
they
vision.
They can't find a fight first.
Whatsoever. ESC doesn't even have trinkets to get the vision.
All right, cocoon onto Key. Sivir ultimate used. ESC trying to turn it around. That's a lot of knockups on SK Telecom, but the damage coming out of Faker and Bang is just immense right now.
Oh,
boy.
Duke.
Transcendent Blades. Duke picks one up. Going to get two.
Oh, that was such a sick kill with two with the Aurelia ultimate right there.
Wow. Meanwhile,
finding
Wolf
him over the wall.
Yeah, that's right. Braum beats Hecarim in the 1v1. Yes, and SK Telecom, they may not even need the Baron here. Emperor's Divide completes the ace, and now SK Telecom should be able to end this game. It took a little bit longer than we expected, but that is it. And SKT going to tie up the series 1-1. GG.
Yeah, nicely played by SK Telecom that game. Bouncing back. But really, you do have to give a lot of credit to the way Bang and Wolf played that 2v2. It really helped secure the Drakes. And even though Bless was able to make a lot of plays on the map, sometimes those plays weren't in the right location.
Yeah.
And they didn't really respect the Drake RNG, even though they had the Callista. So you think that sometimes you just got to let the Hecarim die.
Sometimes you do.
But SK Telecom playing very well around the Drake, and that helps them sew that one up.
Yeah, wow. A little bit of a kind of a weird, awkward game. SKT still looking a little bit sloppy, but being able to get those two Infernal Drakes kind of helped out. They didn't lose Bang early to any sort of cheese. And so there you have it.
Just the preferable trades, too. I think Bang and Wolf really did a wonderful job of opening up opportunities to take those Drakes, because Bengi certainly wasn't doing a whole lot in that game.
That's true.
Had a bit of a failure of a gank in the first place. Fortunately, Duke was able to pretty handily win.